My mineralogy project is about acid mine drainage. I hope to both gain an understanding of the mineralogy of acid mine drainage through testing of the water samples I collected from Bear Valley Mine, and then take that knowledge and compare it to what I've learned about Iron Mountain Mine, a severe example of the environmental effects of acid mine drainage. My dad has been talking to me about rocks for as long as I can remember. As a manufacturer of soapstone, he frequented remote areas of Brazil to keep apprised of the stone supply coming out of the quarries that he then imported to Vermont. Images of these quarries meant nothing to me when I was younger, but I think that seeing these huge pits of rock scarring the otherwise untouched landscape precipitated my interest in the environmental effects of mining. One of the major effects of any type of mining is acid mine drainage. Acid mine drainage is defined as water infected with any type of mineral that lowers the pH of liquid from neutral to acidic. The stream shown here has an abundance of dissolved copper, which results in the bright blue color. This stream has an overabundance of dissolved aluminum, resulting in the bright white color. This next stream has copious amounts of iron in it. The distinctive red-orange color, called yellow boy, is typically associated with those streams draining coal mines, such as the one we observed in our mineralogy field trip. The effect of the high amounts of metals in the water is extremely damaging. Besides significantly lowering the pH of the water, the buildup of precipitated iron oxide in this stream coats the stream bottom with a thick layer of sediment, which effectively stops any sunlight or oxygen from reaching the stream bed, and therefore stifles any sort of life. Iron Mountain Mine, located in Redding, California, is one of the most extreme examples on Earth of acid mine drainage. Ores such as silver, copper, gold, iron, and pyrite were mined in open pit technique from the mid-1800s to the mid-1900s. The mine was classified as a federal Superfund site in 1983, when pH levels as low as negative 3.6 were found in surface water near the mine. This is the site of the most acidic water found on Earth to date. Heavy metals and acid were leaching into table and surface water and effectively poisoning the drinking water of the surrounding towns. Water draining into the Sacramento River killed fish, plants, and wildlife. The dramatic effects that this mine was having on the local population of basically anything living prompted the government to take immediate action. Though not as dramatic or widely known, Bear Valley Mine has its own acid mine drainage concerns. Water taken from the pond located at the base of the whale's back feature had a pH level of 3.41. Water taken from this stream that drains an abandoned underground coal mine had a pH level of 6.7, which, though not as high in acid levels as the Bear Valley Mine pond, has its own concerns, mostly revolving around the iron oxide sludge coating the stream bed. Samples were taken from both the pond, the bottle on the left, and the stream, the bottle on the right. You can clearly see the orange color due to the iron oxide precipitating to the bottom of the container. The first step in the process of the water testing was to determine the pH of each water sample. Sample 1, one of two samples taken from the pond, had a pH reading of 3.41, while sample 3, taken from the stream, had a pH reading of 6.74. However, the part of this research that I was really interested in was testing the levels of iron dissolved in the water. I worked closely with Mr. Tebby, the machinist and instrument technician for the science departments at the college, to create standards and solutions that we could run through the atomic absorption spectrometer to determine how much iron was in each sample. The atomic absorption spectrometer works in this way. A small amount of the sample is sprayed into an acetylene flame. The light emitted by the burning of the metal dissolved in your sample is what indicates the amount of the dissolved metal. In other words, the brighter and stronger the light, the higher the amount of metal. A detector converts the amount of light emitted into data with parts per million units. I decided to test iron levels and found that sample 1, the one taken from the pond, had a 0.0884 parts per million iron, while sample 3 from the stream had 3.1995 parts per million iron. My data is pretty close to what I thought it would be. The stream sample clearly showed that there was a high amount of dissolved iron, but I wasn't sure what the levels of the pond would be. At the end of hours and hours of lab time and copious amounts of strong acid being tossed around, I am left with 2 numbers and 6 tiny vials. I hope through further research I can make a greater connection between my Bear Valley Mine data and Iron Mountain Mine data. Of course, the question is now what to do about it. It's expensive and usually labor-intensive to remediate the environmental impact of acid mine drainage. There's usually two parts of acid mine drainage to deal with: the removal of heavy metals, and then the neutralization of the pH. The first image shows tanks that use ozone as a method to treat acid mine drainage. The second shows a basic limestone neutralization technique. Through further research, I hope to learn more about remediation techniques for acid mine drainage, as well as provide a more meaningful link between Bear Valley Mine and Iron Mountain Mine.